I am Dr. Prabha Devi, professor and other department of OBGY, NRI Medical College. So just I want to brief out about recurrent pregnancy loss. So before going for recurrent pregnancy loss, first of all, should we know what is meant by miscarriage. The miscarriage is termination of or expulsion of pregnancy before 20 weeks pregnancy as per that of RCOG guidelines. But we know there is incidence of 15% pregnancy loss out of total 100 pregnancies, and 1% women may experience recurrent pregnancy loss. What do you mean by recurrent pregnancy loss is any abortion loss more than 3 consecutively without any previous live birth is called primary recurrent pregnancy loss. Having had first live birth, then recurrently and going for more than 3 abortions we call secondary recurrent pregnancy loss. There must be so many causes for this recurrent pregnancy loss. Out of that, most important is genetic factors, and most importantly, they will go for first trimester abortions below 12 weeks. And there may be cause between 12 weeks to 20 weeks pregnancy, like structural anomalies in the uterus or in the cervix. So any woman or any couple who comes with recurrent pregnancy loss should be investigated better in between pregnancies rather than during pregnancy. So many investigations we are supposed to do depends upon their etiological factor, their history and their particular disease. Importantly, we screen for diabetes, hypertension, thyroid disorders or autoimmune disorders like antiphospholipid antibody syndrome. Still there is recurrent pregnancy loss if we are thinking in terms of congenital thrombophilia, thrombophilic factors also to be tested. And it is better always to investigate before pregnancy and give good preconception counseling rather than during pregnancy. And any structural abnormalities like uterine abnormalities, septum, subseptum or submucous fibroid or cervical incompetency, these can be taken care in between pregnancies. And if it is definitely due to cervical incompetency where patient gives history of easy abortion, recurrent abortion and descending order pattern, definitely these structural abnormalities due to cervical incompetence can be dealt by giving cervical stitch after 12 to 14 weeks pregnancy. These pregnancies definitely will go on to continuation and give live birth after 37 weeks. And any congenital thrombophilic or antiphospholipid antibody syndrome patients can be treated with a low dose aspirin of 150 milligrams per day until 36th week, and even sometimes they need heparin, which is injectable, maybe long acting or short acting. Definitely these people can be taken care by anticoagulants if are given very correctly and very consistently. So any couple having had loss of 3 pregnancy losses should be investigated and treated, and definitely we can give again take home baby at least about 50%. So again, the recurrent pregnancy loss people who get pregnancy also should be managed very carefully not to land in complications, because these people may have a chance of again going to gain a portion or preterm delivery or incidence of preeclampsia, eclampsia or IUGR or diabetes. All these should be dealt by an experienced gynecologist or obstetrician and to be dealt in a well-equipped hospital and treat accordingly. These people usually end up with either cesarean section because of the preciousness of the baby, and definitely these babies should be sometimes premature, thereby they better should be delivered in a hospital where equipment is available for taking care of the newborn also. Thank you.